are here today to talk about future of energy with Katarina Naukler from Fortum.
Yes.
Welcome.
Thank you.
So you work with the innovations.
Yes.
What kind of things you do?
Well, we are looking into very different things, but right now I'm focusing very much in three different areas. So we are working with the storage and flexibility, mobility sector, and sustainable and resource efficiency.
Okay, that's interesting. So how does that all, this is a big question, how does that link to the urban environment or cities? If we start with the flexibility.
Yeah, I would actually start with a big question. Mm-hmm. If you think about Europe and the world, we have an issue with the CO2 emissions.
Yeah.
So to be really able to reduce that, the industries needs to go to another direction than today. And actually, it's in the same time really linked with new technology. So what we actually have is really good new electricity production from solar and wind, which in the long run will really reduce the energy prices. So what we see here is that new industries, for example, mobility, will be able to use electricity as the energy carrier to clean up how they, so they can reduce their CO2 emissions.
Yeah. How does it work, actually? We are here in the Nordics and we have sunlight in the summertime, and wintertime we don't have so much sunlight.
No. So that's one reason why we see that solar production doesn't really fit. It doesn't really help us. Mm. We are actually not in the sun belt. But those who are, there it will be a big difference, because the energy production from the sun is already today the cheapest, and it will also just reduce in the cost. So the sun production will really change the world. It will make it really easy for each and everyone in the sun belt to get access to clean and cheap electricity. So think about that. But in the Nordics, we will more be dependent on wind, because we use so much more energy in the wintertime than in the summertime. And wind is better suitable for that.
And this is obviously probably linked to flexibility. Renewables, the sun
exactly.
is shining when it's shining, and
yes.
the wind.
So it's actually back to the physics. You know, electricity needs to be produced at the same time it's consumed. Mm-hmm. So it will be tricky to be weather dependent. So it means that we need to have other kind of flexible resources somewhere in the system. So of course, everything around storage or batteries will be super important. So that's also a link to the mobility sector as I see it, because we from the energy sector could see, you know, it's more batteries on vehicle, and other calls is cars or buses.
Electric vehicles, how does that? You mentioned that there could be batteries on the wheels. How would that work?
Yeah, but you could see that today it's often so that you don't use the car all the time. It's often so, I think it's over 95% of the time it's parked. And at the same time, there is a lot of batteries out there in those electrical cars or electrical vehicles. And of course, if that could be used so we could have smart charging or charge those vehicles when it's blowing or when the sun is shining, and then... you know, use part of the battery as a storage when it does not. So it could be all these devices are more and more connected, and it could do some help in the energy sector.
Do you see that there's like, is it going to be more of the public transport or the private car owners or everyone part of
it? I think it would be easier to have, well, smart charging where you actually are steering when you charge. I think that kind of steering mechanism will be everywhere. But when you're talking about flexibility and even have the car feeding into the energy system, I think it will be easier with the fleets or the vehicles that are in used by companies.
So are you working already with the cities or this kind of companies that have big fleets, or is that yet to come, or when could it be reality?
With the fleet, actually, we are right now doing a pilot in India.
Okay.
But there we have swapping batteries mm-hmm. for light electrical three-wheelers. So we actually own the batteries and the swapping station as an energy company. And the vehicle manufacturer has sold the vehicles without the batteries to the taxi company who's driving the cars. Mm-hmm. So we are, you know, we are three partners that are really connected.
So how is it going? Do you have any insights from that?
Yes, it's super interesting, because actually the drivers can drive much more.
Okay.
Their income is really increasing because they don't need to spend any time in charging. So they could, you know, they can extend the amount of kilometers you can drive through the day, because they just go and swap the batteries. And even if we have now understood that we try to avoid that the drivers are really, you know, pushing the battery to the limits, so they change quite often, and still it's much more efficient for them. So they increase their income. We can optimize the batteries because it's a cooling system in this station, which is important for India, since it could be super hot. So it means that when we charge the batteries, we do it in a way that the battery loves it. So it's ready for the drivers to use it. So it seems to be really, really good. And also it's also something when you drive an electrical vehicle, you get so fast feedback of your driving pattern. So they probably start even in India to drive a little bit more, you know, calmer, because they realize that then they could come further.
Yeah, I also heard speculations about energy, whether energy will be free in the future.
Yeah.
What do you say to that?
I would say that if you look into both solar and wind power production, it's today the cheapest. I wouldn't say it would be for free, but it will be much cheaper than today, especially in those areas. Because if you look into globally, the globe receive as much energy, in 2 hours, we receive as much energy as we use a whole year. So we just need to be able to catch the energy from the sun. And we haven't really succeeded in that. So if you think in that kind of direction, there will be a lot of energy. So energy is not the scared resource in the future. That is not maybe the key resource we should really take care of. But if you look into other materials, that is the key. We should be careful with the materials that we have, and we should reuse them and recycle them. So that's why in sustainability, we need to think resource efficiency, not energy efficiency. It's not so that we should just save energy. We should use energy. We should use electricity from solar and wind and do more. What we do, for example, in Finland, we take plastic, we clean it and make new granulates that we actually do new, or sell it to others who do new plastic things from old plastic. And we just, what we are doing is adding energy. We are cleaning it and adding energy, and then we reuse it instead of taking up new oil and do new plastic.
So there's a lot of different opportunities or options or routes for the energy company to go.
Absolutely.
So there's been mobility, now the sustainability, and the, how about the closed loop economy?
Yeah, I think what we see here is that energy companies are continue or have been working a lot with going into more CO2 free production. But now we can, as energy companies, help other industries, because electricity as an energy carrier from solar and wind is a clean energy. So we could help other industries to clean them and reduce the amount of fossil fuels in other industries. Like, of course, we have steel here as an example in Sweden, or concrete, or the mobility sector, go into those sectors. But also, we could see how we could use materials in another way, as I talked about plastic, for example. But also, we are looking into biomass. Today, we are using biomass also for heating, and that is not bad, but maybe we could use, you know, use other sources for heating, and then we could also look into, can we do something else with the biomass?
What can be done with the biomass?
There's a lot of things. We are just looking into it now, and we have found another method to fraction the biomass, and actually you could do new materials. So we are looking into how we could make textiles, or even if you think about different kind of surface that is using fossil oil today. So out from the biomass, you could actually do more kind of bio oil, if you want to call it like that. So you could replace in furnitures, in other kind of material, or replacing fossil plastic with similar material but coming from bio. The whole energy industry is just in the middle of a huge transformation. And I don't think we have seen the start. Well, we have seen the starting point of it, but it will be a huge change for a lot of energy companies. And where it's ending, I have no idea. But I know that most of the energy companies will not only survive in selling kilowatt hours, because the price level of the kilowatt hours in the future will be low. So you have to do something else. For us, we have really seen that we have different cornerstones in the future of the energy utility. And we see that we could help other industries to go into more CO2-free processes with clean energy. We also see that everything around recycling and biomass is a super important area, but also to how those industries could decarbonize themselves. So it might be so that we need this kind of hydrogen storage and flexibility, but also it might be so that we need also carbon capture and storage to really help other industries to clean themselves.
That's a good mission.
Yes, it's a good mission, and Fortum's vision is really for a cleaner world, and I think that is really what we see. And with that, we see that we can do so much more. When we look into the whole cluster, what can we do? And that's really to clean the world, and we need to go into other sectors and help other sectors to do that. So that's where the resource efficiency came in, because that really needs energy to do that. But then on the other hand, you also see that other threats is coming from other sectors as well. I think the car industry and the car manufacturer also see that, car and transport and energy will merge. So when you buy a new electrical vehicle, why don't you at the same time buy rooftop solar and maybe extra battery, and you have a supplier from your car manufacturer? We see Volkswagen now is starting to be an energy provider. So I think the competition will come somewhere else from.
Than from your own industry.
Exactly.
That makes it interesting.
Very, very.
Thank you for sharing your views on the energy sector and all the possibilities there are. It sounds very interesting, and you are in an interesting field now. So thank you for being here with us today.
And thank you for a really lovely discussion.